everyone, this is Old Empire at servyuho.com. I'm going to show you how you can make custom paintings for your Ultima Online. I'm using PaintShop Pro 5.01, which there's a download for it, I believe, on servyuho. The first thing you need to do is decide what type of frame you want. And it's easier to just use existing frames, that way it's already properly aligned on the wall. You could use an alignment canvas, which I believe I've released those at some point, and align the paintings where you want them exactly. You could have them start all the way at the ground or already be up in the air like this one, where they automatically hang on the wall. You have a bunch of different size frames. You have the standard, which is basically like the red lady, green, purple. This is actually, I always thought it was a clown. It's actually a skull on a shelf. It's a famous painting. And then you have your large painting, you have your ruined painting. You can use all those frames. You can also use the Takuno frames and just about any frame you can imagine. But what I did is I took the red lady and exported it, and then I modified the frame because I didn't like the frames, and I cleaned it up and made it brown. I actually colored it in the game hue 1110, I believe. It's a hair hue, but it makes this nice aged brown. Then I extracted the screenshot. I just captured, using my capture like this, and extracted the image, by selecting around it, and then shift control I for invert. Then that got me the frame. So once you have your frame, you could paste it over an existing image like the red lady. But once you get it there, like I said, you can just use the existing ones if you want. You would just open your red lady. You go to image, deformations, skew. And depending on which way your painting's facing, you either skew 45 degrees to the right or 45 degrees to the left. But once you skew it, you have a square. And now you can see the painting without the isometrics. And see, basically what I did is I took the red lady and I cleaned it up. But I'm not going to use this frame because you can see it's really thick. You only need like a frame of like 2 pixels, but up here you got 3, and down here you got 3, and then you got some unneeded up there at the top. So I just made my own, and this is what mine look like. And then I'm on deformation skew. I mean, if you wanted my frames, you could actually just screenshot what you're seeing right here, paste it into yours. But once you've got it skewed, I'm using a rectangle selection right here. I'm going to select the top corner down to the bottom corner. And you'll get your marching ants, is what they're called. And you choose a painting. Like I did a search for oil painting. You want to find one that's mostly vertical. You don't want a wide painting because it'll squish it too much. But like, we'll use this ballerina just for the sake of a tutorial. Then shift control L, let's paste into. So you might have to try several paintings. A trick I found was to look for really high contrast images, like Control V to paste his new image. And then I'm just going to crop this flower down. Control C to copy it. And now Shift Control L to paste it into selection. Discard the image, don't need it anymore. Then you come to Image Deformation Skew, and you want to skew it back the other way. And it's done. It's that easy. F12 to save. Just save it whatever. And then if you hit Control M, you'll get the mirror image, which all this stuff's up here. And mainly all I'm using is skew, 45 degrees left or right, and mirror, and save to get my images. And I've created a ton of these. So you can see, this is my avatar I use. I just took a small selection of my avatar. Mona Lisa face. See, sometimes it's hard to make out what it is. I can't even remember what that one was. I think it's some type of demon. There's another demon. Succubus. A skull. Another succubus. A nude woman. Call that one the pink lady. Pink flamingo. See, this is what I mean by high contrast. You can really tell what it is when it's... the colors are... complement each other. Got sunflower. This was a church. A rose. Flowers. Boat. A dragon on a mountain. It's really hard to see though. Yin and yang. I even stuck the anonymous mask in there. Raven. Cobra. Wolf howling in the moon. Lotus flower. Then I did the large paintings and I added a bunch of different class types, like female warrior. This is the famous Ultima Online cover with a dragon. This is Age of Shadows cover. Witch from the Wizard of Oz hiding behind a tree. A jester. This is a gypsy dancer. Another jester. Warrior. You can use anything you want. It may not be... The more you squish it, the harder it's going to be able to tell what it is. Like, this is the red dragon from the Great Red Dragon. Famous painting. And then Vigo the Carpathian from Ghostbusters. But you can put all your favorite paintings from real life in UO. This is the famous Vigo painting. But really, it's endless. With that technique, you could literally add thousands, millions, until you run out of, not millions, until you run out of slots. But you can also use this technique to put images onto walls. You can use it to make curtains. It goes on and on. Let's see if... images of curtains. You could possibly use this stuff for textures. You want to stay away from black and white mostly. That's where all your problems, you'll run into problems. Like, I haven't installed these images, so I might have to do some color corrections. I have a tutorial on repairing holes. You can watch that and it'll show you how to fix all your holes, because once you put it into Fiddler, if it's black or white, the RGB value 008 and 00247. If it's above that or below that, like 007 would not show up. So any blacks or whites that exceed those ranges are gonna disappear. But you can just reverse the process. You take a screenshot of it while it's in UO Fiddler, and then you fix the screenshot, and then you extract the image and paste it over the original, and that way you have a new image with the holes fixed. You just have to use black and whites that are valid, that don't disappear. But there's another tutorial about that. But that's how you do it. You can make paintings for days. You could even make a system for painting. You could use empty canvases, have a creature that drops pigments and paintbrushes and canvases, and then have like a special crafting system where you paint and get random paintings, or base it on skill somehow, and or you can just hand these out as rewards with tokens, or however you want to do it. Yeah, sky's the limit. So I hope this has been informative, and good luck.